Hi students, welcome to the video lecture 1 on the topic problems on stagnation properties. So first let me read the problem. Find the Mach number when an aeroplane is flying at 1100 km per hour through still air having a pressure of 7 Newton per square centimeter and temperature minus 5 degrees centigrade. Wind velocity may be taken as 0. Take R is equals to 287.14 joules per kg Kelvin. Calculate the pressure, temperature and density of air at the stagnation point on the nose of the plane. So take K equal to 1.4 he has given. So already speed of the plane, that is the velocity of the body, that is V, already has given 1100 km per hour. So we have converted it in meters per second. So kilometer we have converted it in meter. So it should be 1000 divided by 60 seconds, 60 minutes into 60 seconds divided by 3600. That means we have converted the speed of the plane in meters per second. That is 305.55 meters per second. So pressure of the air he has given 7 Newton per square centimeter. So we have converted it in meter here, 7 into 10 to the power 4 Newton per meter square. Temperature he has given minus 5 degrees centigrade. We have converted it in Kelvin by adding 273. So it is 268 degree Kelvin. So R 287.14 joules per kg Kelvin he has given, where K is equals to 1.4. So using the relation, let us calculate velocity of the sound wave, that is C is equals to root of KRT for adiabatic process. So we have C1 is equals to root of 1.4 into 287.14 into 268. This is 328.2 meters per second. So now it is 305.55. C1 we have already calculated here, 328.2. So my Mach number is 0.931. So now let us calculate first stagnation pressure he has asked us to calculate, because we have calculated this Mach number first, because the formulas Mach number is main here. In order to calculate Mach number, we require the value of C1. For that purpose, we have calculated the value of C1 first, and then with that C1, we have calculated the value of Mach number. Now we'll substitute that Mach number value in this equation. Whereas stagnation pressure is calculated by this equation, PS is equals to P1 in the bracket 1 plus K minus 1 divided by 2 M1 square to the power K divided by K minus 1. So all the values he has given here, P1 value he has given, pressure 7 into 10 to the power 4, 1 plus K value he has given, minus 1 divided by 2, M1 we have calculated. So K value again 1.4 divided by 1.4 minus 1. So after simplifying this value, so stagnation pressure we are going to get it as 12.24 into 10 to the power 4 Newton per meter square. So if you convert it in square centimeters, divided by 10 to the power 4, if we will make this, it will be 12.24 Newton per square centimeter. We will calculate stagnation temperature. Whereas stagnation temperature TS is given by the formula T1 in the bracket 1 plus K minus 1 divided by 2 M1 square. So T1 is 268 in the bracket 1 plus K is 1.4 minus 1 divided by 2. M1 we have substituted the value 0.931 whole bracket square. That will be equals to, if we will simplify all these things in the bracket, so this will be 1.1733. So my total temperature will be 314.44 degree Kelvin. So if we want to convert this answer in degree centigrade, so this temperature minus 273, if we will make it, so I will get the stagnation temperature in degree centigrade. So last we will calculate the stagnation density, where rho s is given by ps divided by r into ts, where r value is given 287.14 joules per kg Kelvin. Then pressure should be taken in Newton per meter square. So already value density is in kg per meter cube. For that purpose we will convert it in Newton per meter square. So already we have calculated pressure in Newton per meter square only, 12.24 into 10 to the power 4 Newton per meter square. So temperature is also in Kelvin only, we'll substitute in Kelvin only, because density is in kg per meter cube. So rho s is equals to
it is 12.24 into 10 to the power 4 pressure P divided by R value is already given. So temperature is 314.44. So if you will simplify it, so my density will be 1.355 kg per meter cube. So this is my final answer. That is, we have calculated stagnation pressure, stagnation temperature and stagnation density. So this completes the module, that is compressible flow. So problems are very, very simple. Even derivations are also very simple. So you can attempt one full question from this module very easily, and direct questions are there for the problems also.